Hi, this is Trucking Biker. Welcome to Trucking Life, OTR. In this next series of videos, I will be giving you an inside look at our lifestyle and showing you what it's like to be an over-the-road trucker. So stick around and let's have some fun. Thank Flying Eagle One for asking me to be a part of his Trucker's Life series and do a OTR version of it. And I'd like to thank you guys for taking the time to watch. So, my name's Steve. Hi. My wife's name is Gayla. We are Truck and Biker. Okay, a little qualifying information. My wife's over there trying to make me laugh. Back in 1996, I went to Swift Training School. Went solo after that for that's not true, because me and my brother went to Swift Transportation over there in Salt Lake. They sent us to the Ogden Community Center to go through the training part, the school part where you get your license. And we had this big idea. We were going to go, you know, run team. We're going to go through school together and then we're gonna run a team. Well, we did that, and we ran a team for like a month. And then he got his own truck, and I went solo for the next 5 years. And in 2001, I met Gayla, and she went through school, and we've been team ever since. So all of it's been OTR. So what does OTR mean? OTR, regional, and local, is basically your three types of truckers, okay? Aside from, you know, the trailer that you pull, you have, you know, your locals who get home every day, your regionals who get home every week, and your OTRs who get home sometimes every 2 weeks, sometimes so it's OTR get home between every 2 weeks and 6 weeks. Some companies, a lot of companies, require that you stay out for 6 weeks before you go home. They don't care how long you stay out. At least, you know, nobody cares how long you stay out, because the longer you stay out, the more money you make for them. It's just that you're not at home, and that's the big thing about being OTR, is that you're hardly ever at home. As far as living in the truck, most of the trucks that the companies issue are condos. They're the sleepers are 48 to 52 inches wide. You know, you've got your, you know, your kitchen. It's your kitchen. It's your bedroom. You know, it's your living room. There's a little bit of getting used to doing that, because you're actually living in your truck more when you're OTR than you're at home. Gayla and I, we stay out for a month and then we go home for about 5 days. So we live in this truck four times longer than we live at home. It takes some getting used to. You spend a lot more money out here. Somebody who is not in the trucking industry can go to any McDonald's or Starbucks or Barnes & Noble and get free Wi-Fi. Not at a truck stop. Not at most trucks. There are some truck stops that will give you free Wi-Fi. So there's a, for instance, they've got a captive audience, so to speak. So and that transfers all the way all through their store into their restaurant. You get to see just about every part of this beautiful country. and it's not all the same. We really do have a beautiful country, and I feel lucky to be able to see it. Most people I know, they'll never see anywhere near what I get to see. So I'm pretty lucky that way. I'm making more money now than I ever had in my life. And that's not saying a whole lot. If I go get a local job, they're only going to want to pay me 10, 15 bucks an hour. Flying Eagle One, you know, in his videos, he likes to tell you at the end of the video how much he's made that day. Well, you got to remember, he's what we call out here suicide jockey. He hauls fuel. He's a rolling bomb. And so there's something to be said for that, you know. So he gets, he'll make a little bit more money. He's not going to make that kind of money hauling dry freight, you know, or a dry box. Local, there's no way. The difference between team OTR and a regular, you know, OTR is teams don't stop. I mean, they do, but. Between New Jersey and Knoxville, where we're at now, we've stopped maybe an hour to switch this morning, you know. And when we go across country, a lot of times with our LTL runs, there's no time. There's no time for stopping. They used to tell me that solo drivers or team drivers couldn't run out of hours. Buddy, you can, and we have. About a year ago, Gayla had to take off. She had to have some surgery, and I went solo, and felt like I turned around, and I was out of hours. I had a call. I was 120 miles from my delivery out in California, and I had to call up because I was doing my log, and I realized I don't have the hours to get there. And it's not like in the old days where you can, you know, just make a new log or whatever. It don't pay to falsify your log and make things look right, you know. That's the difference between solo and team, you know. Solos run out of hours really fast. They got all kinds of time to make videos and exercise and eat and take a shower every night and all that. Team drivers, they don't have that kind of time. There's a lot of times they don't have it. The time, they put them under the gun, you know. And as a result, because of that, teams are a desired commodity. I mean, we can go anywhere and work for just about anybody because we're a team. Now, a solo driver can work for anybody too, but the companies will do just about anything they can to acquire a team and keep a team. And that, I mean, that's for obvious reasons. I think I can make some pretty interesting videos. I mean, it's not going to be an everyday thing, and I'm not going to make you, you know, watch me driving down the road a whole lot. You know, if there's something neat that I think you'll enjoy or something like that, then I will go ahead and record it. What I would like for you guys to do is I'd like for you to put down in the comments what you would like to see. What kind of OTR video would you like to see? Click on that little link down there and go to my page, and there's a box there with that question. What kind of videos do you want to see? What kind of OTR videos do you want to see? And write it in there, type it in there, and then other people, you know, come in, see what your question is, and vote on it, and we'll get videos that way too. So, and while you're there, go up there to the top and hit subscribe. That would be a good thing too. That's about it for now. Like I said, my name is Steve. My wife's name is Gayla. We are Truck and Biker. And this is a trucker's life. See ya. So we picked up in Edison, New Jersey last night. About midnight, they let it go. And we have to be down in Irving, Texas tomorrow at 6 o'clock in the morning.
Irving.
What?
Irving.
Irving? What did I say?
Irving.
Irving? Did I say Irving? Irving, Texas. What is that, Dallas? So, we are just west of Knoxville right now. And we've got 820 miles left to go. Just started raining here. Today yet. And there it is, the sun.